Project Matrak is funded by the Interreg Maritime Programme and involves several partners, where INM is the coordinator, CNR Imati, University of Genoa and IFERMER from Toulon. The strategic objective of the Matrak project is to improve the monitoring protocols of marine waters in ports by means of smarter, cheaper, and safer monitoring procedures. In particular, the project deploys a new adaptive sampling strategy based on real-time sensors mounted on a robotic platform. The project answers the needs of more efficient environmental monitoring procedures. Using new technologies for real-time measures, it is possible to make on-the-fly decisions and to overcome the traditional sampling strategy where the sample positions are fixed and selected a priori. In order to implement this new procedure, a geometric representation of the environmental domain where environmental parameters are mapped is necessary. In particular, the geometric model of the marine waters could have a very complex shape, bounded by seabed and pier structures. On the one hand, a tetrahedral mesh would better approximate the water volume, but in this case, there is not a straightforward application of geostatistical estimation methods. On the other hand, VOXEL representation allowed the direct application of geostatistical techniques, but at a lower representation accuracy of the domain. The geometric model, together with the real-time measurements by new sensors, provide a digital twin of the Genoa Harbor, and using this model to compute the optimal path of the displacement of the robotic platform, we have directed the obstacle of the avoidance that usually in traditional implementation is managed by human operator. Now we will show you the steps of a sampling strategy. To start the procedure, an initial set of samples is needed for a preliminary estimation. This set could be selected in different ways, random positions or using expert suggestion or using a priori information derived from previous surveys. The second step involves acquisition and preprocessing of raw sensor data. Preprocessing of data consists of synchronization among collected variables and GPS positions, and transformation of data in normal data in order to apply specific geostatistical methods. Next step involves the calculation and fitting of the variogram. The variogram is a function describing the spatial load distribution of the environmental variable. It is possible to compute it from collected data, and then it is possible to fit it with a function to identify the parameter of interest, seals, range, and nugget. The fourth step is geostatistical analysis, in particular sequential Gaussian simulation. SGS simulates several possible scenarios for the same variable in every point of the domain. The average of the values return a single estimation map, and the variance define an uncertainty map. At this point, the procedures come to a crossroads, and a criterion of convergence is evaluated. If the expert is satisfied with the estimate, for example, the certainty is below a certain threshold, he can stop the campaign. Otherwise, the sampling continues. The next position is selected based on the uncertainty map, and the next point is selected where the uncertainty is maximum. When the robotic platform reaches this new point, it samples new data. Furthermore, new sensors allow also to collect the data during the displacement of the robotic platform. And the procedure loops from step 2.